When you think of an intelligent machine, what comes to mind? Does it look like this? Or this? What about this? If intelligence could be embedded in everyday objects, what kinds of problems could we solve? Take the workplace. As much of the economy shifts to office work, poor environmental quality is having a direct effect on worker health. In the long term, these conditions can increase the risk of obesity, musculoskeletal disorders, and even cancer. Unfortunately, workers' habits are deeply ingrained, so just giving them the option to stand isn't enough. But what if instead of making you sluggish and sick, your desk helped you feel and perform your best? What if it was tailored just for you? That's the goal of this intelligent workstation, designed collaboratively by engineers at AirUp and researchers at USC.
We're starting with building a smart desk and looking forward to the future of what would be a intelligent workspace.
Provide some sort of feedback to the user and sense what the user is doing.
How can we build intelligence to these desks so that they can support more comfortable and more productive and healthier environments?
Together, the team is using the latest advances in sensing and machine learning to transform the way we work. The project represents a new way of interacting with machines, bringing together both cognition and embodiment. The mind and behavior of both desk and user symbiotically co-evolve.
The desk mind works with the human mind and enables the desk motor functions to change the human's motor functions.
So how does it work?
There is a sort of a data hub that can be really, you know, different depending on which computer you use. And then there is the sort of sensing and the communication hub, which at the core of it, at the center of it, is a Raspberry Pi. And using Bluetooth and Wi-Fi is able to then connect to the building or app infrastructure.
So we're constantly monitoring the user, physiological responses of a person, as well as the ambient environment around the user.
The sensor that we typically have are environmental sensors, measuring, for instance, temperature, humidity, air pressure, but also a distance sensor. So we use a distance sensor to check the height of the desk, but also we have higher resolution cameras looking at posture using machine learning to understand whether a posture is correct or not. And then I would say the limit really is imagination and what kind of availability of sensing technologies there is.
To help users improve their behavior without becoming intrusive or annoying, the desk has to understand when and how to engage. Getting the balance right means building a relationship, and the key to that relationship is trust.
We want to understand what people prefer in terms of level of autonomy and how the desk could accommodate this.
How do we provide feedback that isn't obstructive, but at the same time isn't something that somebody's going to automatically start ignoring?
The goal of collecting all this data is to get away from a one-size-fits-all approach.
Systems are designed for the standard user, but if you don't fit in that standard user bucket, you're either too hot or too cold and not comfortable in your space.
By observing how we respond to different environmental cues, the desk can gradually learn our needs and preferences.
Ultimately, a network of intelligent workspaces, desks that you can take the AI with you when you go to a different office and it knows your preferences, it can continue to help you be healthy.
How can we utilize this to change behaviors, to change habits, to move towards that healthy lifestyle, and to improve productivity and performance?
It starts with a desk, but eventually, this kind of intelligence could pervade our lives.
The desk is the kind of springboard to allow, I mean, sort of implement technology that is really embedded in a way that is more subtle.
Creating life for something that is so regular, an office desk. I think that would be a tremendous achievement.